Hi everyone, welcome to my channel, Knitting for Baby. Thank you for watching and thank you for subscribing. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to knit this hat for a child between 4 and 6 years old. It's very easy to make. I made this hat using the seed stitch, which is a very easy stitch to do. Now, I also show you in the same tutorial how to make it for adults. The only difference is the number of stitches that we need to cast on and the number of rows here that we need to work. So you can also make it for adults. Okay, so let's get started and thank you for watching. Okay, to begin, I'll be using these 9mm or US 13 circular kneading needles. These are 32 inch. And I'll be using this super chunky King Cole Big Value. This is, let's see, in this color, oatmeal. Now, this would be the equivalent to a bulky number 6 here in the US. So you can use either. Okay, so to begin, I have cast on a total of 48 stitches. Now, I'm making this hat for my son, who's about 5 years old, almost 6, and his head circumference is about 52 centimeters or about 20 inches, so he's got a pretty big head. So we're going to make this hat for him. So it would be for a child between 5 and 6 years old. Now, I made a hat in the same way for myself, this one here. This one here, I cast on 56 stitches, so multiples of 8. That way it's easier for us to reduce the crown. So if you want to make it for adults, then you can do it in the same way, just cast on 56 stitches. This one here fits perfectly on me. I have a head circumference of about 56 centimeters, which is about 22 inches. So if that's what you have, then I think this is going to work for you. Also, the stitch is very stretchy, and I actually put this on him. It fits loosely, it's just that it's actually too long. So if you want to also make it for like a teen, I think it would also fit. Just make sure that you don't do too many rows here before we start to close. But just thought I showed you that. So the hat that we're making here, I'd say it's for a child between 4 and 6 years old, because the stitch, like I said, is very stretchy. Okay, so let's get started. Now, the method that I'm going to use to make this hat is using the magic loop. So the first thing that I did is I cast on my stitches. Like I said, I have 48 stitches, which is a multiple of 8, and make sure that it's an even number of stitches. Also, I'll leave a link to a hat that I did recently where I showed you how to cast on your stitches using the long tail cast on. So I'll leave both links down here in the information box. Okay, so enough talk, let's get started. Okay, so I have 48 stitches. So with the magic loop, we want to make sure we divide these stitches here. Now, what I like to do is just do this and then right in the center. You don't have to be precise. You can have more stitches on this side than on this side. It doesn't matter. The important thing here is that we divide these stitches here. So pull this loop like this, or the wire like this, and bring your stitches to the front of the needles. Now, make sure that this working yarn is always on top of your needle here. Now, we're going to push this because this is going to be the side where we're going to begin, since we're going to start here to join in the round. So this hat, like I said, is going to be worked in the round. Now, I really don't like these kneading needles because they tend to get in the way. I like my Shiagu, I think that's how you pronounce it, needles better because they don't get in the way with the wire. Okay, so here, make sure that this yarn, which is coming from the skein, is on top of this needle. Now, pull this needle, and we're going to join to the first stitch. The first thing that we're going to do is our the edging on the hat. So I'm going to do knit one and purl one. So with this needle here, we're going to join here to the first stitch. Now, this first row is always a bit hard because it's the first row. So insert your needle like this, and we're going to knit the first stitch like this. Knit. Now we're joined. Now the next stitch we're going to purl. Next one we're going to knit. And next one we're going to purl. This is all I'm going to do here. I want to make sure that I finish with a purl. That's why we want to have even number of stitches here. So knit and purl all the way around this first row. So I'm just going to show you here to show you how we're going to change needles. So I'm probably going to fast forward this part because it was just knit one, purl one. I'm here at the end of this side, so knit and then I'm going to purl. Remember, whatever your last stitch is here. So mine is a purl. Depending on how many stitches you have, you might have a knit, so it doesn't matter. Now I dropped this needle. I'm going to turn this like this, okay, and I am going to pull this needle and push my needle like this. So pull your wire and then push your needle and then pull the needle in the back here. Make sure that your yarn is always, so it's always in front of this wire here. Okay, now we're going to begin knitting this side. And same thing, remember what your last stitch was here. For me, it was a purl. So this next stitch I'm going to knit. And then the next one I'm going to purl. Now this part is the same. I'm not going to show you. I'm going to finish this off camera, but I will come back and show you once I'm here at the end how we're going to transition to the other side to begin the second row. Okay, I'm here at the end of this first row. Like I said, my last stitch has to be a purl because my first stitch was a knit. So perfect. So my last stitch is a purl. Now we're going to drop this needle, we're going to turn our work. Now we're going to pull our wire like this so that this needle comes here where we have this stitches, like this. Now push your needle like this. Make sure that this yarn, it's always in front of this needle here in the back. Now pull this and then grab the needle in the back, and we're going to begin our second row. Now, I recommend you put a stitch marker here to remember that this is the beginning of the row, but I have this yarn here in front, so that reminds me that this is the beginning of the row. So now, make sure you pull on this here so that it closes that stitch nice and tight. So now we can begin the second row. Now, for the second row, we're going to repeat the same thing. We're going to knit the knit stitches and purl the purl stitches. So this first stitch here is a knit, so I'm going to knit. The next one is a purl, so bring your yarn in front and insert your hook through the back leg of this stitch, like this, and purl. Knit and purl. Now, we're going to do this for about, I'd say about 5 rows. If you want this part here wider, then you can add more rows. I think I'm only going to do about 5 rows because this is a bulky yarn, and 5 rows, I think it's enough. And this is all we're going to do. So continue, do this part here. I already showed you how to transition to the other side and then how to begin the row. So we're going to do this, like I said, for 5 rows. So I'll meet you at the end of the 5th row. Okay, I did a total of 5 rows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, what we're going to do from here on, before we start, I'm going to put a stitch marker right here. This is the beginning of each row. So I want to make sure that I know that. So the stitch that I used to make my hat is the seed stitch. So this is a two row repeat. So the first row, you knit one, purl one, knit one, purl all the way around. Okay, just like we did here. Now, the second row, your knit stitch is going to be a purl, and then the purl stitch is going to be a knit. So you do the opposite, and that creates this textured look. That's what it looks like. So this is what we're going to do. So technically, we already did the knit one, purl one, which is the fifth row here in this case. So I'm just going to start with the purl row. So here, the first stitch, I'm going to purl. The next stitch, I'm going to knit. So purl and knit. Purl and knit. Purl and knit. And this is all I'm going to do all around. Just alternate between a knit and a purl. So continue, and I'll meet you right here where I have my stitch marker, which is the beginning of each row, to show you what we need to do next. Okay, I'm here at the end of this first row to our pattern. So this is my last stitch. So here I purled, so this last stitch I'm going to knit. Perfect. So we finished with the knit stitch and we started with the purl. So you know that our pattern is perfect. It's going to continue in the same way. So now I'm going to drop this needle. I'm going to turn my work here, pull your cable so that this needle comes here to the front. Oops. Like this, push your needle. And now this is our second row repeat where we're going to knit the purls and purl the knits. Now pull this needle. This first stitch here, I purled. So in this row, I'm going to knit. So you're going to knit through the back leg like this or through the center and knit. The next stitch, we're going to purl. So knit, purl. And the way that you can tell which one is which, the purl stitch has a bar right in front. So in the previous row, we purled. So in this row, we're going to knit. And the knit stitch doesn't have a bar in front. It has this V here in front. So in this row, we're going to purl. So you knit the purls and you purl the knits. That's all we're doing. Now continue like this for this second row and I'll meet you at the end. Okay, I'm here at the end of this second row. This is my last stitch. So in the first row, we knit the last stitch, but in this row, we're going to finish with a purl. If you did everything correctly, you should finish with a purl because now this is the beginning of the row. So drop that needle, turn this like this, and pull your needle through these stitches here. Now this would be your third row. So what I like to do so that I don't lose my place, because sometimes your needles can lose your place, just keep moving the stitch marker up to the last row that you did. That way you know that this is the beginning of each row. So now for the third row, in the second row, we knit the stitch. In this row, we're going to purl the first stitch like this, and then knit, purl, knit, purl, and knit. This is all I'm going to do. I'm just going to repeat these two rows. Remember, you knit the purls and you purl the knits. It's all you're doing. I'm going to do this, I'd say, for about 24 rows. I'm not exactly sure, depending how long I want to make this part, and then I'm going to start to reduce. So I'd say about 24 rows, because for me on this one, I think I did 28. Let's see, that's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30. Actually, I think I did 30 rows. So I'm sure for my son it's going to be less rows. So continue watching and you'll see exactly how many rows I'm going to do. So continue and do these two rows. You knit the purls and you purl the knits. That's all we're doing all around, and then repeat the same thing. So continue and I'll meet you at the end of that row. Okay, I'm here at the end of the 23rd row or the 24th. I can't tell. So let me measure it for you. I think it's the 23rd row. So let me measure it here. It's about 16 centimeters, which is almost 6 inches. So let's see, we started here. So that would be row, let's see. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then there's two rows here. So that'd be 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. And then that's 22. So I think it's row 23 that we're on, but anyways, I gave you the measurement, so it shouldn't measure about that. If you're off by a row or two, it's okay. We're going to start now to reduce. So I've placed some stitch markers here, every eighth stitch. So from here, this is the beginning, I have 8, then 8, 8, 8, 8, and then here at the end, we are going to also reduce. So I'm going to move this stitch marker here to the front, this stitch here, because I'm not going to put a stitch marker here at the end. We're just going to have to remember that at the end, before, you know, we start the new row, you're going to also reduce. Now, to do this row, what you're going to do here is, let's see, where's my yarn? Always your yarn needs to be in front. So, is it in front? Yep, it was in the front. Okay. Now, this next stitch for me, I have to purl. So I am going to purl. So purl the next stitch. This is the beginning of the row. And then you're going to knit the next, purl the next. So let me count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So two stitches before our stitch marker, we are going to knit two together or purl two together, depending on what this next stitch is for you. For me, I have to purl this stitch, so I am actually going to purl. So I'm going to change the direction of the next stitch. So I'm going to remove this stitch for a minute and then change the direction of the stitch behind it, which is the one that's right in front of this stitch marker, and I'm going to put this other one back, and I'm going to purl these two together like this. Now, depending on which row you're in, like I said, you may need to knit two together. But the important thing is that you knit or purl the two stitches before the stitch marker. So move the stitch marker to the side. The next stitch I need to purl, knit, purl, knit, purl, knit, purl. Whoops, nope, I don't need to purl because I'm two stitches from this stitch marker. So same thing, I'm going to remove this for a minute, change the direction of this next stitch like this. It doesn't really matter, it's just making it easier for us to purl our two stitches like this. It makes it so much easier. So if you forget, it's okay. And now, again, I'm going to repeat the same thing past my next stitch marker. So my next stitch here, I need to purl. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then the two stitches before the stitch marker, I am either going to purl two together or I'm going to knit two together. For me, I am going to purl two together. And that's all we're going to do. The important thing is for you to always remember that from here on, you're going to knit or purl the two stitches that are in front of your stitch marker together. So continue, finish this row, and I'll meet you at the end to show you once again how to reduce on the second row reduction. Okay, I'm here at the end of this first row reductions. I just need to finish here. I have two stitches, so same thing. This is where we begin each row. Remember what I said? So right before we start this second row, we need to also reduce here at the end. So I'm going to purl these last two stitches. Now, in this first row of reduction, you should have a total of 42 stitches. Remember, we started with 48, so we reduce 6 stitches. So that's a total of 42 stitches for this first row reduction. Now, for the second row reduction, we're going to pull a wire here. And we're going to do the same thing. We're going to reduce up to these last 2 stitches. So here to begin, I have to knit this stitch here. So now here, knit the first stitch, purl the next, knit, that's 3, 4, 5. Now, these 2 stitches before my stitch marker, we are going to purl two together. So I'm going to move this stitch here temporarily to change the direction of the stitch in the back, put it back, and then we're going to purl two together. You may need to knit yours depending on which row you finished. It's okay as long as you're consistent. So pass your stitch marker to this side and then repeat. Knit, purl, that's 2, 3, 4, 5. Same thing, we're going to purl these two together, but I'm going to change the direction of the stitch here in the back, and I'm going to purl two together. Pass your stitch marker and repeat. This is all we're going to do for this second row. At the end of this second row, we're going to have 36 stitches because again, we're going to reduce 6 stitches. Continue and I'll meet you at the end of this row. Okay, I finished the second row. I forgot to record here where I knit the last 2 stitches here. You should have 36 stitches here for this second row reduction. So don't forget to knit 2 together or purl 2 together here at the end. We're always going to do that. Now, for the third row, we're going to start here. So I'm going to purl, knit, that's 2, 3, 4. Then I have my 2 stitches here before my stitch marker. So I'm going to change the direction to the stitch here in the back, which it is, so perfect. So now we're going to purl two together. Now pass your stitch marker and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4. See, I almost did that. So I'm going to pass this. Actually, I don't need to because this is fine. If I change it, then it's going to be twisted. So I'm going to purl these two together. Pass my stitch marker and same thing, start with the next stitch. So purl, 1, 2, let's see, 2, 3, and then I'm going to pull this again, wire, push my needle. Let's see, knit, and then these last 2 before the stitch marker, we're going to purl two together. And that's all we're going to do. Now, this is all you're going to do, so at the end of this third row, you're going to have 30 stitches. Now, for the fourth row, at the end of the fourth row, you're going to have 24. At the end of the fifth, you're going to have 18. At the end of the sixth, you're going to have 12. And at the end of the seventh row, you're going to have 6. So continue and I'll meet you once we have 6 stitches here left to show you what we need to do next. Okay, I'm here at the end of this row of reduction. I think this is row 7. If I count it correctly, I have 6 stitches. So as long as you have 6 stitches, we're okay. So now what we're going to do is we're going to finish one more row. So we're going to reduce these stitches a bit further. I removed my stitch markers. You can do the same thing. If you haven't, you can do so here where we're going to do this. So here we're going to purl these two together. And we're going to push this through, and we're going to purl the next two together. And then again, purl the next two. These are the last two here, so I need to pull my wire right here. Perfect. Remove this one and then purl these last two. Perfect. Now we should only have three stitches. One, two, three. So here, let's see. Yes, three. Is it three or two? Actually, no, it's two. Two stitches. No, three. Three stitches. So now we're going to cut our yarn. Leave a nice long tail. I don't know, about 8 inches. Pass this through a needle. And now we're going to remove this needle. Now, this is the beginning. So we're going to go around through the back like this. So just insert your needle there, your needle with the yarn, and then just push your needle out. It's easier, just remove this. Just going to unscrew this. And then just pull your needle. And there should be a little knot there automatically. So like this. Now, this is a reversible stitch. So for me, this is going to be the right side because this is where you can see where we did the reductions for the crown. See how you can see the little pinwheel here? So I like to see this on my hats. So I'm going to leave this as the right side. It's a reversible stitch. There's nothing wrong with the other side. I just prefer this other side. So here's the finished hat. That's what it looks like from the top. There it is. So my hat is done. Now, this hat here is for a child between 4 and 6 years old. For my son, it's perfect. He's almost 6, but for a 4-year-old, it might be a little big, probably a little long, but you can always fold it and it should fit perfect. This stitch has lots of stretch, so it should work for a 4-year-old. So now here's the adult version. Now for the adult, if you want to do the adult, you're probably going to do 4 rows more. I think for this one I did, let's see, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28 rows. So you can do 28 rows and then start the reduction in the same way. Everything will be the same. So the only difference is that you do more rows to make it longer if you want to make the adult version. And for this hat here, I cast on a total of 56 stitches. So still a multiple of 8. So that way we divide here to reduce every 8 stitch. And the same thing for this one. This one we cast on a total of 48 stitches, also multiples of 8. Okay, so this was today's tutorial. I hope you like it. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time.